everyone. I hope you're well. We're here in the Rose Garden with Sister Sheila today to say our prayers. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the
Holy Spirit. Amen.
Have a beautiful day.
Hi.
Our virtual classroom. Today we will be doing something different. I know since last summer you guys have been asking me to do a science class. Well, I figured out a way to do it in our virtual classroom. So today we will be covering the eight planets. I hope you're happy, Miss Amanda. I know you've been asking for a science class for a long time. And since you guys gave me so much great feedback and you wanted to have another class outside, that's where we set it up. Among the stars. I'm not crazy about the bugs, but if you guys want it outside, it's your choice, your classroom, and let's have some fun. Joining us in our science class today are Gary, Amanda, Angie, Ashley, Rebecca, Shanice, and Stevie, who seems to be looking at his phone, like always. He better be looking up some information on the eight planets. Okay, guys, here we go. Let's start our class.
Eight planets that orbit around the sun. Come on, we'll introduce you and name them one by one. Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune.
Earth days, as a matter of fact.
I am Venus, my atmosphere's super hot. I spin backwards in a way the Earth does not. I am closest to the Earth in distance and size. I have no moons, I hope you can sympathize.
I'm Earth, the planet that you're on, you know. I'm terrestrial but covered in H2O. I collide with things that I can't avoid, but my atmosphere protects me from meteoroids.
I'm Mars, and you can jump higher on me, because I have a third of Earth's gravity. I hear you plan to visit soon. I'll be your first destination since the moon.
I'm Jupiter with my 79 moon crew, like Io and S2003
J2.
Yeah, you could say I have a pretty large girth. Here's a storm twice the size of your mama Earth.
Oh!
My name's Saturn, check out my pretty rings. These rings are a few of my favorite things. I'm a giant made of hydrogen and helium. And please stop hitting me with things.
My name's Uranus and I'm an ice giant.
That's dope.
I was the first planet found with the telescope. I rotate backwards and on my side I smell like rotten eggs, but that's just the hydrogen sulfide.
I'm Neptune, I'm the windiest planet around. I got supersonic winds that's faster than sound. An ice giant with 13 moons and a dark vortex that may go away soon.
And I'm Pluto.
Pluto, beautiful, but yeah, we've been over this, and you're considered a dwarf planet these days, so...
Girl, I'm the biggest object in the Kuiper Belt.
Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars,
Jupiter,
Saturn, Uranus, Neptune,
sing along real strong for the next two.
Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars,
yeah.
Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune.
And I guess not Pluto.
Well, guys, that was pretty awesome, huh? Which one's your favorite planet? Can you draw me a picture and tell me why? My favorite planet is Neptune. I love it because it's a brilliant blue. It's got those supersonic winds that sound really cool. And did you know scientists and astronauts believe Neptune contains liquid diamond oceans? That's crazy, right? Liquid diamond oceans. So here I am, trying to imagine what a liquid diamond ocean would look like. There's the formation and precipitation of diamonds, and there's a bunch of layers over it, which would be ice and water and ammonia in the atmosphere. And at the very bottom, there's molten rock. But could there really be a diamond layer in the middle? Wouldn't that be awesome? This is what I think of. This is what I see in my imagination when I think of a liquid diamond ocean. Imagine swimming in there? I can. I can see myself swimming all around, but I'd probably have to have a diver suit because it looks pretty cold in there. Okay, guys, just wanted to share my ideas. So tell me, what's your favorite planet? Can you draw me a picture to see what's inside your imagination? I can't wait to hear from you. Until next class. Hi, everyone. Welcome back to our virtual classroom. I can't believe that in the 4 years I've been at the Marian Center, it never occurred to me to have an Italian class. What was I thinking? It's like the most perfect thing ever. We come from Italy. The Marian Center has all this love and history and culture and beginnings from the Little House of Divine Providence in Italy, where St. Joseph Benedict Cottolengo was born. How is it that we haven't done an Italian class? Well, that's about to change. And even though this is a virtual class, when we get back to a real live class, we're definitely going to keep exploring this. But for now, let's get started with our virtual class. I'm going to have Sister Fausta help us just in case we get stuck. So here we go. So, where should we have our Italian class? Maybe we could go outside and have our class in the park, or we could design a cool classroom with Italian decorations, flags, souvenirs. That would add a nice Italian feeling. I mean, it's not like we could go to Venice and drop a projector from the bridge over the canal and have our class right there. We can't do that. Or can we? We can do anything. We're the Marian Center. We dream big. So, what do you say we have our first Italian class right here in Venice, sitting on a gondola under the stars with a beautifully lit canal? What do you think? Should we do it? I'm thinking you guys would love it. And Angie and Rebecca seem pretty comfortable too. All right, so we've got Anitra, Sister Fausta, Rosita, who needs to move a little bit back because she's making me nervous sitting on the edge over there, Angie and Rebecca, who are super comfortable, Arlen, and Natasha, as always, taking notes in the back. So let's get started on our Italian class. Instead of doing the traditional 1, 2, 3 colors and alphabet first, we're going to try something a little different. Today's lesson is Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star in Italian. Why did I pick that one to be our first lesson? Because it's beautiful. Because you're going to remember it. And because I really like it. So here we go. Thank you. Let's see if we can all try and remember and practice the title, Brilla Brilla La Stellina, which means Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. When we're back in live class, we will come back to these lessons, and before you know it, we'll be singing in Italian at one of our programs. I hope you guys enjoyed this as much as I did.
Hi guys, hope you guys are okay, healthy as ever, right? And we continue to pray for you guys as well as you praying for us, right? Well, today Miss Agnes wants to share a little Bible story class, right? Like we have before, and want to discuss one of our favorites that we talked before. And that is about the fruits of the Spirit, right? Right now you see this is a beautiful bowl of fruits, right? God's creation. Beautiful bowl of fruits. But are we talking about fruits like these that we eat? Or we talk about the Holy Spirit, the fruits of the Holy Spirit? That's something that we what? We nourish it, right? We try to learn about it and put it in our hearts, right? That's what we want to do today. Today we want to talk about that, you know? So, the Holy Spirit, right? So, again, like I say, let the Holy Spirit guide you. And when it does, your life will bring what? Fourth fruit. And the fourth fruit are, which you can probably not see all together, but I will read it to you. Okay? So this is the tree of the fruit that the Holy Spirit tells you about. And one is joy, love, goodness, gentleness, self-control, kindness, faithfulness, patience, and peace. Those are the fruit of the Spirit. Those are the spirit of the tree of fruit that Jesus wants us to nourish that, right? To know that that is the fruits of the Spirit, right? Right, like Miss Agnes said, and she explained to you, these are fresh fruits, right? We eat these fresh fruits, but the fruit of the Spirit, it's something that we nourish in our spirit, in our mind, in our heart, okay? And Jesus wants us to share with each other, okay, the fruit of the Spirit. And again, I would tell you, it is joy, it is love, it is goodness, it is gentleness, it is self-control, it is kindness, it is patience, it is peace, right? All that fruit of the tree is the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is telling you, if you can have all this, then you have the fruit of the Spirit. Okay? And you have to work with each one of them. Joy is not easy all the time. Love is not easy all the time. Kindness is not easy all the time. Self-control is not easy all the time. Right? Goodness is not easy all the time. Patience, world, it's not easy all the time. And most of all, peace. Oh, peace of mind. It's not easy. But he tells us, we work on this tree, this fruit of the Spirit. We work on this. We nourish ourselves just like we eat a fruit and we eat it and we enjoy it. That's what he wants us to do with the Holy Spirit. He wants us to nourish all this in our hearts and let it come out, right? Let it come forth. Let your fruit show to other people. But do you have to do it one time and then that's it? Oh, no. You have to do this every day. You have to read his word. You have to nourish. You have to speak to the Holy Spirit and say, Spirit, I need patience right now. The peach is good, Lord, but I need patience. I need patience, right? I need the spirit of patience, right? One day you may not be in control. The banana is great. Oh, this banana is great. Yes, thank you, Lord, that you created everything. Banana's great. But right now, this time, at this moment, I need self-control. So I'm asking for the Holy Spirit to give me self-control. Right, guys? That's what this is about. The tree of the fruit of the Spirit. Okay, guys? We talked about it in class. We will talk about it again. Okay? We will continue reading Bible stories in class when you come back. All right? We'll continue doing scriptures, right? God's word, right? Pray always and don't give up. Pray always and don't give up. That's right. Right? All this, don't give up. You still pray, right? Because he's right there with us. He's right there helping us to maintain our what? Self-control. And self-control is what? One of the what? Holy Spirit is one of the fruits of the tree, right? One of the tree, right? So guys, at home, do that. You know, go into your Bible or ask your parents, you know, to find you the chapter or where, or just Google it. Miss Agnes is always telling you, Google everything. And find the Holy Spirit, the fruitful spirit tree, okay? And when you see that tree, and it'll tell you all the spirits of the fruits, the peace, joy, love, goodness, kindness, faithfulness, self-control, gentleness, okay? All that is on the tree of the spirit of fruit. Is what Jesus wants you to know. That's what he wants you to carry. That's what he wants you to carry on your heart. The spirit of the fruits, okay? Say them to each other every day. Say it to yourself every day. Oh, right now I need the spirit of self-control. Right now I need the spirit of patience. I think I need that spirit of love right now. I think I need that spirit of kindness. I need to be kind right now. What is the spirit man doing? He helps you. He helps you, right? Right? That's what the Holy Spirit does. He helps you. So I say, let the Holy Spirit guide you. And when it does, your life will bring the fruits, will bring forth the fruits. You feed your mind and your heart, and it will turn back around and return it back forth to the ones around you. Understand? You feed yourself peace, and peace will come out. You feed yourself love, and love will come out. You feed yourself kindness, and kindness will come out. Okay? Remember, the Father and his Son Jesus, and who? And the Holy One, Spirit. And the Spirit has these fruits. The tree of the fruits. Go over them, meditate with them, Talk to your parents with them, your family, and yourself most of all. And they will help you through the day, through this time that we're going through. Okay? Sometimes we're confused with a lot of things, but you know what? Just talk to the Spirit, and He will guide you to the right one. Okay? All right, guys. I love you. Miss Agnes, we'll come back soon to you. All right? Keep watching the videos. Bye-bye.
Okay. Hi, everybody. I'm here with Anna, Amanda, Miss Carol. We're going to teach how to sing in sign language if you're happy and you know it, okay? So the first sign is F, is your pinky. Pronunciate if you're happy and you know it, see? If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands, okay? If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Then the other part is, if you're happy and you know it, then it's like this, see? Your fingers like that, from your thumb to your index finger. Then your face will surely show it. Got that part? That was a little more difficult. Let's try that again. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will truly show it. Okay, let's start from the beginning. Okay? If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Right? If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. One more part is shout. This is the word shout. Okay, this, we're gonna say, if you're happy and you know it, shout. And this is hooray. Let me see my hands. Hooray. If you're happy and you know it, shout hooray. Got it? Okay, are we ready to sing or should we practice a little more? You need to practice a little more? Let's practice a little more. From the beginning, we're gonna practice everything, okay? If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Okay? Did we say shout? You already said shout. Shout hooray, okay? You ready to sing it, Miss Carol?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Nice and easy, everybody, okay? Ready?
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're and you know it. Clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, shout hooray. If you're happy and you know it, shout hooray. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, shout hooray.
Hooray, everybody. Yeah, they did a great job. Thank you, ladies. Thank you, Miss Carol. Bye, everyone.
Hi there, it's Miss Carol again. This is my helper, Miss Anna, and she's going to make a crab to go in with our ocean mural here. And we use part of a paper plate, paint, scissors, glue, pom-poms for the eyes, and pipe cleaners to make the legs for this crab. And she's already going to start. She's chosen red for the crab, so you can start painting there. You want to hold it with the pipe cleaner, or you can hold it with your hands, either way, and so until you get down to that. Just paint the whole thing over. Use big brush strokes because it's going to have time to dry a little bit. Just get big strokes. Hold it with your hand, one hand. You don't have to hold it with the clothespin until you get, take big strokes. Yeah, because you're going to cover that whole thing. Don't worry about the paper.
Hmm.
That's a girl. Using mud paint, and then it'll cover the whole plate. Okay, we're back, and Anna has painted the body of her crab, and it's pretty well dry here, so we're going to turn this over so she can put the legs on her crab. So she's going to take her scissors and just cut each one of these in half. Open them up real wide. Oh, up here. Can you cut them? Mm-hmm. Okay, let's see if I can do that quicker here. Let's see if we can get them all. Yeah. And then you're going to be putting where you want to put their legs. Okay. Now we're going to put three legs on each side. So pick three legs and we're going to glue them on each side. You're going to do this way. They are three on each side. So pick where you want to put their legs. You're going to be sticking out there. Just put three lines of glue. Here, wherever you wanted, three lines of glue going out this way. Let's see, because we got to get it so that they'll really stick. There, there, and there. Okay. Now pick three over here. We're going to do three more over on this side because you got to have three legs on each side so he can walk. That's a girl. One, two. Okay. So now put your. That's a girl. Move them up a little bit because we want them to be able to crawl around on the ground. That's our girl. There we go. We'll press them down good. We'll put more glue on top of them after we lay them up. We'll smother them in glue. Okay, Anna's got her legs in place for this little creature, and she has to put her pom-pom balls on there for the crab's eyes. No, you have to put the pom-pom, put the glue on there. Did you put glue around it?
Mm-hmm.
Here, just lay it down, yeah. And then put some on the pom-pom too. Put some on the pom-pom, and pick up the eyeball, put a little bit on the bottom of the eyeball. Put glue, that's our girl. Okay. Okay, and here, this one. Okay. And now, put a smiley face on your, make him happy. There you go. Okay, thank you for watching her make her crab that's going to go in the ocean mural. Stay happy and healthy. Bye-bye.
Hello, my Marian Santa family and friends. As you know, we have been talking about our Under the Sea mural that we're creating over here. So today I'm going to talk a little bit about the starfish and the jellyfish. So have you ever thought about what's the difference between a starfish and a jellyfish? Well, I have, so let's see if you thought about it too, and can we come to some kind of conclusion of what is the difference? Jellyfish and starfish are beautiful animals. We all know that, right? They have different colors. So they share a few similarities. Even though they look nothing alike, both lack brains or skeletons. And neither are fish at all. They are marine animals, meaning they live in salt water of the ocean. Aside from these similarities, jellyfish and starfish are very different. Starfish, also known as sea stars, did you know that? Are classified as echinoderms because their bodies are made of calcium carbonate components called osseoles. Starfish, which can regenerate limbs, can have anywhere between 5 and 50 arms, depending on the species. Starfish also have a small eye spot in the middle of their bodies that allow them to differentiate between light and dark. Jellyfish are classified as cnidarians because they have tentacles that sting. Have you ever been stung by a jellyfish? From my understanding, it does not feel good. They are basic organisms with a thin layer of skin and a primitive digestive system,
Most species are extremely small, but some have tentacles up to 100 feet, guys. While starfish are solid creatures, the jellyfish is very slight. It is 95% water. Starfish have hundreds of tubes on their underside that work like legs to push the starfish forward. The tube legs can act like suction cups the starfish will use to stick to or climb walls or rocks. So if you're at the beach, you want to look out for that. Starfish can move up to 20 feet per hour. Jellyfish are free swimming creatures. They ride the ocean currents to get from one place to another. They have limited control of where they're going when it comes to horizontal movement, but have muscles to move up or down. Have you ever wondered how starfish and jellyfish hunt? Hunting can be different. Starfish use their legs to pry open the shells of a prey, like oysters and clams. A sac-like stomach comes out of his mouth, oozes into the shell, then retreats back into the starfish body. Most of the jellyfish diet is composed of zooplankton, comb jellies, and occasionally other jellyfish. The jellyfish will wait for prey to float into its tentacles. It will launch thousands of tiny filaments into the prey, and the barb-like ends of the filaments will inject the prey with venom. That sounds a little wild, right? Tiny arms around the mouth of the jellyfish bring the immobilized food in for consumption. The habitat of the starfish and jellyfish can be found in every ocean in the world. Starfish usually stay on the ocean floor or cling to the rocks near the shore, but occasionally float on the top of the water. Depending on the species, jellyfish will be found in shallow waters near the coastline or middle waters deep out in the open sea. Have you ever went to the beach in the ocean? Have you been out and seen jellyfish or starfish? Have you ever been stung by a starfish? If you're out at the beach, maybe it's time to look for some. Just take a picture. They can be different colors as you see. Some of them are very pretty. And you can see, take you some pictures and find all the good color ones. The difference between the jellyfish and the starfish, you can see different colors. And you will see some now on our mural. So it's coming alive. So you will see a lot of different things under the sea over here. When it's all finished, we will be happy to show you everything. Thank you for joining me today. Have a nice day and stay safe. Bye.
Good morning, everyone. Today we have to play volleyball. Ooh! Thank you.
Now we do a yoga.
Two child's pose or
bunny pose.
Yoga exercise.
It's a little bunny sleeping in the garden.
Bunny.
And then push yourself up. And look at your toes in downward dog pose. And you can even wiggle your bum, your bottom a little bit.
Wiggle.
And then lower yourself down into happy puppy.
You're not even hurting your knee
there. Remember what he does?
Straight. Like a puppy. Straighten your legs. Look at Samantha. She's
That's
laying
back
down.
And rock pose.
It's your stomach that goes down, Andrew.
I know, but I can't.
And we're going to do lion's breath. Because a lion, he roars, right? So, this is rock pose, nice rock pose. Arms straight out, almost on your knees. Nice straight elbows, arms, good. And then you're gonna take a deep breath in. And
you gotta pay attention. You're gonna be a lion.
All that air. Okay, sit up again. Don't forget, you can stick your tongue out too, because he's roaring. We're not roaring, we're just letting our breath out really strong. You ready? Deep breath.
Lion.
Make sure you make your eyes really big and open, really wide too. Let's try that one more time. Breathe in. Nice. Okay, now we're going to find our way to our belly. Lying down on our tummy. Ready? Your arms, your hands right by under your shoulders. Good. Keep your feet on the ground, and we're gonna do cobra. Remember, what does a snake say? He hisses when he gets up. So, okay. So head down. And push yourself. Push your head up now. Hiss.
Ooh, a snake.
Lower down. Slowly. Like a sleeping
we're not using the knees. We're on our stomachs.
When you see something, your head goes up.
Let's go.
Take a deep breath in and push yourself up.
On your stomach. On your stomach. There's nothing wrong with
you. Lower yourself down again.
Just
put your arms beside you. Your head down. Just take a rest for now. Let's stand up now.
Get up.
Let's have mountain pose. Remember mountains?
Mountains
stand up tall. And every life is great. So the itsy meetsy buttercup pose up to meditate.
I did him. I'm back.
Let me look.
One, two, three, four.
Thank you for joining us for 1, 2, 3 Kids Yoga on Namaste Yoga.